In our studies over the last few months, looking at the assessment of the churches, we have seen that for each of the churches, there are distinct rewards. So when we look at the church in Thyatira now, we find another set of distinct rewards. Ruling over nations, being given the morning star. So we want to look at those who will be given this particular reward of ruling over the nations and of the morning star. These rewards are meant to motivate us to be engaged in what is required of us according to the set order. There is a way to do them. We are motivated to do it according to the set order so that we can obtain the rewards. In 1 Samuel chapter 17, from 23 to the following, we discover that when David went to the camp where his older brothers were to find out how they were doing, to give them some things from his father, whilst he was there, he saw Goliath come out and challenge Israel. He said, not all of you, just send one man to come and fight me. If I defeat that fellow, then you will be our servant. But if that fellow defeats me, then we, Philistines, will be your servants. And he heard the soldiers around say, look at this man, he has been threatening us for the past 40 days. We've not been able to present a champion. And do you know what the king has said? The king has promised to give to whosoever will fight this fellow tax exemption. His first daughter as wife, meaning that man will become a prince and in the royal family. And David heard that. David said, wait a minute, what did you say will be done to the man who defeats this uncircumcised Philistine, who is threatening the armies, the host of the Almighty God? They rehearsed it again in his ears. He said he has made up his mind to go to do it. Then his brothers came and said, we know you. You are up to no good. What are you asking for? He said, what have I done? I'm merely asking a simple question. What will be done to the man who defeats this fellow who is harassing the kingdom, the nation of Israel? That's all I'm asking. It motivated David. Even though he didn't really get it because he was a man who was making that promise. But it motivated him to do certain things. On one occasion, when King Saul wanted to kill David, but he didn't want to kill him with his own hands, he promised himself, okay, I will give you my first daughter. But the man that will marry this man, he changed the rules, said the man that will marry must bring, was it 70 skins, that is quarter sacks of soldiers. The man, you must go and handle 70 soldiers and kill them and remove their scrotal sack and bring. What was he going to do with the scrotal sack? Only God knows. Then he went. And I think he brought, was it double of that or so? He brought more than was expected of him. Still, the king remained. The bottom line, where what we're trying to lay here, there was a reward. It spurred David to do certain things. In Hebrews chapter 10, we are also encouraged to let the reward spur us to have confidence in God. Hebrews 10 verse 35. It says, therefore, do not cast away your confidence, which has great reward. Your faith, there's a reward for your faith in God. So don't cast it away. So because there is something that we expect, we hang in there. We hold on to the Lord.